some of the stuff that I have that I consider to be pretty cool. Maybe, you know, maybe some people have the exact same things. I'm sure a couple people have the same things. I mean, I have a couple, you know, consoles and everything, so figured I'd show, and this isn't gonna be ultra in-depth on everything. I might make another video showing in more in-depth my video game collection, but once we get to the video games over there, what I'll probably do is just show the ones that I think are really worth noting, like the special editions. So, I just have, you know, this poster from Battlefront. I went, GameStop was having kind of a little party for this game's release, so I went to that. We got my, my video game console boxes up there, PS4 Pro, Pro Controller, new Nintendo 3DS, that's an original boxed Game Boy, and my Wii U up there. Here we have my NES, my original Wii, and that's actually a Japanese exclusive Orange Pikachu N64. And we have my books. Again, not really gonna go super in-depth, just the ones that I think are really worth noting. These are the first considered canon released Star Wars books by Timothy Zahn. They introduced probably my favorite Star Wars character of all, Grand Admiral Thrawn. This is a fun read, 1001 Video Games. You must play before you die. Actually, one day I want to go through and make this list and cross off the ones I've played and find the other ones. Because I'm a huge fan of Xenoblade, I have the Xenoblade, I think it's, yeah, the Monado Archives. Well, in Japanese, but the art is nice. Most of the Warriors books. The Cirque de Freak books, Harry Potter, Percy Jackson's down there, Lord of the Rings, Hunger Games. A couple others down there. Probably the two most interesting ones for gamers are those two. This cool little, I don't know if you'll be able to see it on the camera, but it changes to different dragons depending on how you're looking at it. And then this shelf I really like, Last Guardian, Golden Scorpion, Metal Gear Solid 5, and Doom, all came from Collector's Editions. Nice pan shot there. And then also down here, I apologize for the lighting we have. I don't know how to pronounce it. I think it's Katabukiya or whatever. A figure of Metal Gear Ray. Dark Horse figure of Ganondorf from Twilight Princess. And then the Katabukiya 1 in 100 the scale Metal Gear Rex. Some anime Fruits Basket complete collection. I actually have two complete collections. One of them I got originally, and then I got the special edition one. Bleach, which is one of my favorite animes. I love it, Bleach. Naruto, which is my favorite anime. And some Zelda books. And then down here we have the Link Between Worlds Collector's Edition, the Skyward Sword, and Spirit Tracks guidebooks, Xenoblade Chronicles X, the Super Mario Sunshine, that's the Diablo box. Back there is the Pokemon X and Y. I have two handbooks, basically, is what they're called. These are a bunch of Game Informer magazines and my magic cards. And then my dumbbells, my 20s and my 40. Before we go over more, let's show, that's the Ganondorf box, obviously. The Rex and Ray boxes. That's an ornament. Don't really know where I got those. That is actually all three of the Christopher Nolan Batman's Blu-ray. It comes in a nice book. It comes with special edition pictures, this nice case. Just a really nice set. Silverbolt. And collector's Luke Skywalker figure back there, but I'm not gonna attempt to grab that. Some vinyl figures. Cartman. And then probably can't see it well, but the mess of cords back there. A Zelda Breath of the Wild poster I got for going to the midnight release. I apologize. apologize for the lighting. A nice bionicle that I made that I think is pretty cool. And then I have my controllers in this nice little CD rack on top of my subwoofer. The Wii Pro controller, the Wii and Nunchuck, the Wii U Pro controller, PS3 and PS4. Again, you probably can't see it very well, but trust me, they're all there. And then let's get down here. There's a decent sized TV. The sound bar for the stereo and the Wii sensor bar. That's Shrapnel and Optimus Prime. My original PlayStation 1. This switch on the bottom actually lets me switch between, I think it's the N64, GameCube, and PS2. That's my capture card. And my original SNES. And then my stereo, which I really like, which I'll show all the speakers for. But I love having a stereo. And then for consoles, as we saw the box, I have a PS4 Pro, my Wii U. I don't have the box for it, but a PS3, my fat PS2, an N64 that actually does have the expansion pack, and then my GameCube, which is an actual original GameCube, which means it has progressive scan support. And here I just have a chair that I can sit in, like, to be closer to the TV with my leather jacket. So the right front speaker is actually down here for the stereo, and then the left front is right here. This over a little bit, we have my Generation 1s, just real quick, Starscream, Optimus Prime, Perceptor. That's actually a really cool box set of the entire franchise, not counting the movie, but I have two copies of the movie. It comes with the entire series, 98 episodes, all four seasons, a booklet that kind of describes every episode, and actually his character bios. Two magnets, and it all comes in this really sweet packaging. Soundwave, Skylynx, Megatron. Again, apologize for the lighting, so you're probably not going to be able to see it very well, but Ultra Magnus is back there. Original Bumblebee and Power Glide. Smokescreen, right here. This is actually a triple pack of Shrapnel. Shrapnel, Kickback, and Bombshell, the Insecticons. Astro Train in his original Japanese coloring, and a Generation 1 Blitzwing, along with a broken wheel jack, and a McDonald's toy from years and years and years ago. Can't really see it, but there's a VHS and a fighting game, like, joystick with all the buttons and everything. Rock'em Sock'em Robots, and a couple board games. And then we get into some like the actual meat of the room, basically. These are just some Zoids. These two are from Chaotix Entry. These ones, I'm not sure. I absolutely loved Chaotix Entry, though. It's one of my favorite shows. And then, like, my 3DS and DS games. This is the Happy Home Designer with the UFC bundle. Pokemon Sun and Moon. Fun fact about that, the dude handed me Sun. At GameStop, I pre-ordered it. The guy handed me Sun, and I was like, wait a minute, shouldn't I have both of them? And he looked at my receipt and was like, oh yeah, shoot, dude, sorry. They were really busy, I didn't give him a hard time about it, you know, make mistakes. It's not like I went home with one of them and then had to go back, you know, he corrected it immediately. Both Majora's Mask and Ocarina of Time. This took me forever to get the box for. It was one of the first games I bought for the 3DS back when I got it. However, I didn't have the box. It was used. So I actually spent $15 for just the case, basically. So, yeah. case, but I'll do it more in-depth, like, hey, look at, you know, okay, Final Fantasy, choose, you know, I'll go through and show every game specifically that I own, in case you missed one. And if I do that, I'll probably shine, like, my phone light on it so it's easier to see. This is a really good deal. This is all Mega Man Zero games. I got that for maybe, I think, $20. That's a really good collection to have if you wanted to play Mega Man Zero, which I recommend. They're great games, except for Mega Man Zero 1 can be a little too difficult for its own good sometimes. And then here, these are mostly Japanese, so I'll run down real quick. Xenoblade Chronicles X soundtrack. These are all soundtracks. So Xenoblade Chronicles X, Xenoblade Chronicles, Shadow of the Colossus, the Mother 1+2 soundtrack, Final Fantasy VI. This is probably the most expensive, the single most expensive one that I got for the cheapest. I got this for like $2. Super Mario Galaxy soundtrack goes for a ridiculous amount the last time I looked on Amazon. And then this is something I got for pre-ordering Twilight Princess HD and getting it day one. GameStop exclusive pre-order thing. This is Okami's special edition soundtrack. And then this is actually the original Pokemon trading card game on the computer, like it's a tutorial. And then if we move this chair back and look up here real quick, we got my special edition shelf. There's Doom, The Last Guardian, Xenoblade Chronicles X, in between Earthbound and Xenoblade Chronicles X is actually a copy of Fire Emblem Fates Special Edition. In the back there is Final Fantasy Type Zero Special Edition, Metal Gear Solid 5, and Mortal Kombat X Collector's Edition. So, got a couple special editions. Wanna have more one day, but you know, money. For a while, the only PS4 games I had were actually steelbooks. I had Doom and Final Fantasy XV steelbook, Metal Gear Solid 5 steelbook, and The Last Guardian steelbook. And it's only when I started getting some of these that, like, I stopped getting nothing but steelbooks. But I actually have, what, 3, 4, 5 PS4 steelbooks. So 6 steelbooks total, I think, because I also have Final Fantasy XII steelbook. So that's fun. You can see a little bit. This is actually not even a game. This is actually the special edition discs for this game. It's like its soundtrack and everything. This is Demon's Souls with its guidebook, actually. And Dark Souls 1. This is the limited or special edition. Over there, RE4, and I don't know if anybody knows. PS4, or the PS2 copy of RE4. I actually have Bubsy back there. A box copy of Donkey Kong Country 2. A plastic box for Earthbound. A box copy of Mystic Quest, Final Fantasy 4, and Final Fantasy 6. A plastic boxed copy of Mega Man X. This is actually Mother 2, which is Earthbound in Japan. Super R-Type, because I really love R-Type. I actually have R-Type Final, and I was working on getting every ship. This is the GameCube 2 game, the Game Boy player. This is Dracula X Chronicles. R-Type Command. The third birthday Parasite Eve, which, you know, I hate third birthday, but I love Parasite Eve 1 and 2. Eternal Darkness, fantastic game. Luigi's Mansion, Resident Evil 0 and 2. Speaking of Resident Evil, the GameCube GameStop exclusive steelbook for Resident Evil 4. This is actually complete in box and everything. So, I have the PS4, PS2, Wii, and GameCube versions for Resident Evil 4. And I found out that there's actually a steelbook PS2 version, so I want to pick that up. RE4, for anybody that doesn't know, is basically my, like, go-to stress relief game. Like, it is, Resident Evil 4 is basically the game that I can go to any time of the day, no matter how terrible I'm feeling, and play it, and I'll have a good time. I love Resident Evil 4. It's one of my favorite games of all time. Absolutely adore Resident Evil 4. Some PS1 games in my NES collection. Plastic case Metroid back there. Box copy of Metal Gear, actually. Then my N64 games. I've got a Japanese copy of Ocarina of Time. Plastic box Star Fox 64. Yoshi's Island. Diddy Kong's Racing. And one or two others. A box copy of Sonic. And then most interestingly, probably, is the box copy of Mother. For the Famicom. It's actually complete in box with everything. And then I'll open this up if I do a more in-depth, like, show every game that I own collection tour. Because I really, especially because a lot of people are sleeping, so I don't want to be making a bunch of noise, but in there is a Pikachu Edition Game Boy Color, a original Game Boy Advance, and all my Game Boy Advance and Game Boy Color games. So, including but not limited to, Metroid Zero Mission, Metroid Fusion, Fire Emblem Sacred Stones, and just a bunch of other ones. I played a lot of Game Boy Advance back when I was younger. My bad. My pooch. My girl, Onyx. Rawr, 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 rawr. Pitbull Lab Mix. Love my pooch. Love my dog. I have no idea where this ever came from. I tried to look it up. Couldn't find it anywhere. So I have no idea if this was packaged with, like, original release Metroid Prime copies. I have no idea. But it's sweet. I love it. It's been around for years and years and years. My uncle was actually going to throw it out, and I took it. This came in my Metroid Prime 3 guidebook. Xenoblade poster, because I absolutely love Xenoblade. Right rear speaker. Plastic sword. My tablet. Kisuke Uehara's Shikai Rukia's. A cool sword that I bought. And that's actually real. That's a master sword from Zelda. It's actually real metal. It's really well made. I really like it. And this is where my ass sits when I'm recording Let's Plays. So, appreciate the chair. Giant, whatchamacallit, peep, because why not? PS4. PS Vita and PSP underneath it, my original DS. I actually have an original 3DS, but it's my sister is using it to play Pokemon Moon. And my new Nintendo 3DS. Frieza Pop Vinyl in my 3DS carrying case. Dobby figure. Madara figure. Some Naruto cards and a wristband, and all the Akatsuki rings. Left front, or left rear speaker. That's actually the full Spirit Tracks map. All the rails and where all the bunnies are and everything. You got the Kalos region and then the Alolan Islands there. My grab sword, and if I'm gonna zoom in here, there's actually a Chippendale pin from when I went to Disney World. If anybody doesn't know, when you go to Disney World, you can kind of trade pins around with the workers there. And when I went, my goal was to basically get as many Chippendale pins as I possibly could. Why? I never watched Chippendale. I don't know, but I like them. A pig. A baby pig from Minecraft that never stays up. Fennekin, I think. Pikachu, Froakie, and Kirby. I really like this Kirby. Really like that Kirby. Pac-Man. Only thing I've ever won from a claw game. This Goofy is actually a souvenir from Disney World. A cool Mega Man figure that I haven't seen before. Like, since. This actually came with, Link Between Worlds Special Edition Guide. These two came in the Amiibo Festival. Wolf Link Amiibo, 8-Bit Link, Shovel Knight, Lucas, Ness, Shulk, and Ike. Tom Nook, Goldie, Rosie, and Stitches. Those are the Amiibo cards. I really like this Nintendo stand for the Amiibos. And let's sit down. We got my Wii U gamepad over there. Glasses that I never wear, my sunglasses. Some Pokemon stuff, a couple of Minecraft figures, because why not? And then my nice headset that I wear. And my computer. That's where all the magic happens for recording. So that's basically it. That is my room, relatively. You know, got the consoles and everything. Every single one of those are actually hooked up. So I could play any of those, really. I think the only one that's not is the PS2. And all I have to do is plug in the power supply back there, and then I can play it. But there's not enough room in the power strip to plug everything in, so the PS4, Wii U, PS3, and 64, and GameCube, I think, are all hooked up. Other than that, you know, I mean, I like a lot of what I have. I think I have some nice stuff. You know, worked a lot to get all of this. Still work a lot, so still paying for you. She eats everything. She has eaten so many things that I have to replace. Oh, but I love my dog.
Love my girl.
So I hope everybody enjoyed. If you did, please let me know. Hashtag like if you like dogs. Seriously, though, like if you enjoyed, I guess.